mental. In Australia, we suspended our parliament for 15 days, National Day mourning. The ABC sent 29 journalists to London to cover the Queen's death. What the fuck are you doing? What's the latest on the Queen, Richard? She's still dead, Michael. It's important that I'm here. No one else is touching the story. Dude, she died on a Friday. That weekend, I drove past a McDonald's. They were flying the Macca's flag at half mast. I'm sure that's what she would have wanted. I was so moved. Saw that, pulled over, sang the national anthem. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba! Every politician lost their goddamn minds. There was a guy at the Queensland Parliament from Bobcatter's Australian Party who gave a speech about the Queen in which he described her as the Michael Jordan of aristocracy. Which I would argue is the Mozart of shit comparisons. Thank you, sir. The funeral was fucking nuts. I read an article about a gay sauna in London called the Pleasure Dome, okay? They announced that on the day of the Queen's funeral, they would be staying open as a gay sauna. But as a sign of respect for Her Majesty, they wouldn't be playing any music and they'd be broadcasting the funeral on every TV screen in the venue. And that is the most British shit I've ever heard in my fucking life. The idea of the Queen's funeral playing in the background as dozens of pasty confirmed bachelors bugger each other in mournful silence, gently sobbing as they go at a corgi style. Just, oh, yes! This one's for you, Lizzie! Hands down, the best reaction to the Queen's death came from an Australian rugby league player. Her name's Caitlin Moran. She's a First Nations woman. She's a Gamaroi and Anaiwan woman. She plays for the Newcastle Knights. On the day that the Queen died, Caitlin Moran posted a photo of the Queen and she tweeted this. Today's a good fucking day. Uncle Luke announces his tour and this dumb dog dies. Happy fucking Friday. Now, I don't know about you guys, to me, that's Australian of the Year shit, okay? Referring to the recently deceased 96-year-old monarch as this dumb dog. That is fucking Prince Philip level insensitive. And she got punished so severely. She got suspended for a match. They docked 25% of her pay. And she had to go to these compulsory classes to learn about the responsible use of social media, which is fucking outrageous. Sending a rugby league player into an educational environment is one of the cruelest things you can do. They're going to get eaten alive. Fuck that shit, man. I hated all of it. Fuck the monarchy. I've never been a fan, but over the past couple of years, holy shit, they have royally jumped the royal fucking shark. Fuck them. Fuck this racist, outdated, anti-democratic, corrupt, imperialist institution that just justifies the fucked up, unequal class society in which we live. Fuck the dead queen. Fuck Prince Andrew. Fuck King Charles III, His Majesty, the King of England. Fuck him and his giant, fat German sausage fingers. Oh, didn't he look amazing at the coronation with the sword of destiny and the orb of forgiveness and the fucking slippers of noncery or whatever the fuck he was wearing? Fuck the royal family. And that includes Harry and Meghan too, by the way. Some people are like, oh, do you like the royal family? Or are you team Harry and Meghan? You're allowed to hate all of them. And I encourage you to do so. Fuck Harry, that balding helicopter war criminal with his frozen little todger. Fuck him! And fuck Meghan Markle and her faux naivety. Oh my God, you guys, I married into the royal family. And guess what? They're weird! If only there had been some signs. Oh, leave us alone. All we ever wanted was our privacy and a Netflix deal. Fuck them. Now, I know this is not particularly radical for me to say, okay? Sex Pistols called them a fascist regime in 1977. Hundreds of comedians have told literally thousands and thousands of jokes about how ridiculous and outdated and anti-democratic this institution is. And in the grand scheme of things, yes, there are far more important things to worry about. At the same time, they're still fucking there. Still going in the year 2023, the year of our Lord. The royal family just keeps going, coming back. They're like fucking herpes or Australian Idol. And we can't seem to get rid of them here in Australia. Do you want a republic? Yes, the people are rising. The movement is unstoppable. Yeah. Well, Do we get a day off for that or what? That'd be time and a half, eh? I agree with you. I just don't think we can do it. We can't get rid of the monarchy. We couldn't get rid of plastic bags in this country, okay? Truly, Charles and Camilla are the greatest plastic bags of all. Don't think about that joke. It makes no sense. Of course we can't get rid of the monarchy. We can't change anything in Australia. Fuck, we hate changing things in Australia. Can't change anything. Can't get rid of the monarchy. We can't change our fucking constitution. Can't change the date of Australia Day. Can't get rid of the Lord's Prayer. Can't fucking legalize weed. Can't fix the fucking internet. We couldn't get rid of Neighbours, for fuck's sake. Neighbours! Neighbours had a 37-year run. Came on air, we had a big farewell. We said, bye-bye, Neighbours. Thanks for everything. Time for something new now. And then Amazon came along and said, no! More Neighbours! We've got more to learn from Tony and Carl and doctors. Just fuck off and die! Fuck, give me a show and fuck off! All right, that was a bit much. We can't become a republic. What do we do, have a president? Can you imagine anyone saying, hi everyone, I'm the president of Australia. Get the fuck out of here. No one would respect, the president of Australia would have the same authority level as Donut King. Okay, same vibe. We're not a real country. Anyone? Hello? What are we? We used to be a British prison, now we're just a US military base. Pretty soon we're gonna be China's Bali. Okay, that's the future, come on. Once we run out of shit to dig up, the whole economy propped up with Chinese schoolies, okay? They're not getting Bali belly, Aussie ass, mate. Fucking Aussie ass. Not getting Bali braids, rat tails and mullets, okay? Rat tails and mullets. Following their rich red strings back to their noodle shops, whatever the fuck that means. We're not real. I've been to other countries. They don't think we're real, okay? At best, we're a Simpsons episode to the Northern Hemisphere. A few years ago, I was in London. I got into an Uber, and the guy said, hey, mate, where are you from? I said, I'm from Australia. I said, oh, yeah, where's that? What am I supposed to say? South, mate. It's south from here. I've never had to give directions to Australia before. Steal a loaf of bread and turn left, buddy. You'll find it. I said, oh, it's kind of near New Zealand. And he said, oh, yeah. What the fuck, man? We're a continent, sir. Have some respect. That's the Northern Hemisphere. No one gives a shit. No country in the G7 has ever been like, hang on, everyone. Have we run this by Australia? Have we checked this big important thing with Australia? Like, oh, fuck it, those criminals will be fine. If they're not, what are they gonna do? Write us an angry email in 12 hours? Who gives a shit? I think the rest of the world thinks of Australia the same way our society thinks about the elderly, okay? They live far away, their opinion doesn't matter, and if you talk to them, you're gonna hear something racist.